Our text, Hebrew 11, verse 26. Esteeming the reproach of Christ greater riches than the treasures in Egypt. Our heading, he looked to the reward. Be sure also that he had to tear himself away from many a friend. In the course of 40 years, one would suppose he had formed associations that were very dear and tender. But to the regret of many, he associated himself with an unpopular party, whom the king sought to crush, and therefore no courtier could henceforth acknowledge him. First, for 40 years he lived in the solitude of the desert, and he only returned to smite the land of Egypt with plague, so that separation from all his former friends must have been complete. But, O true-hearted spirit, should it break every fond connection? Should it tear every soul away from all that you love? If your God requires it, let the sacrifice be made at once. If your faith has shown you that to occupy the present position involves complicity with error of sin, then break away by God's help without further negotiations with sin. Let not the net of the fowler hold you, but as God gives you freedom, mount unconfined and praise your God for liberty. Jesus left the angels of heaven for your sake. Can you not leave the best of companies for his sake? Second, Moses was willing to take upon him the reproach of Christ and to bear the affliction of God's people when, well, I venture to observe again, there was nothing very attractive in the people themselves. They were wretchedly poor. They were scattered throughout all the land as mere drudges, engaged in brick-making. And this brick-making, which was imposed on them for the very purpose of breaking down their spirit, had done its work all too well. They were utterly spiritless. They possessed no leader and were not prepared to have followed them if they had arisen. Application. They received him at first, that is now Moses, but when the prophet's first action prompted Pharaoh to double their toil by an attachment that they should not be supplied with straw, they upbraided Moses at once, even as 40 years before, when he interfered in their quarrels. One of them said, "Will you slay me as you did the Egyptian yesterday?" And I pray, mercy, Lord, in Jesus' name, amen.